Hi, Nye. Hello. My name is U Kirsted U Akpik. Tamangan Arawamik. I'm based in Ottawa. I will be making a Pualuk mitten. Tungasugit, welcome. And I will be using thin wool material. Here's the pattern. A pattern is called Ututi, Ututi. There are three pieces. This is the main piece. And then there's the second piece where the thumb will be. And the third piece is marries all three pieces. Takoa. Ututi tamauna na magyali. You have to line them up with this curve here. This curve here on this piece. And this curve here to line them up. Takoa. Atulanga javu. Ammalo. And I'll show you the needle and the sinu. The sinu I will use. So that pattern was the liner. We have the leather pieces for the outer, and they all look the same, same shapes. However, when you cut your liner, you will cut inside the lines and with the outer. Maybe you can see a bit of the line. You cut outside the line. Ivalo is the sinu. I just remembered. That's the sinu, ivalo, and the needle, mikputi, mikputi. And this is a Glover needle. It's very sharp. Tana mikputi kakitiuti ipitualo. It's very sharp. When you thread your needle, you're going to take a small, the other end, there's the needles threaded. You're going to take the needle and your thread, done. Make sure it's wrapped around. You could hold the needle with the thread now. Okay, you're going to twist it. Okay, this is how my mother taught me. And the sewing ladies in school, you twist it. You're still holding on to the two pieces of the thread, and you're going to thread the needle through. And now you have a knot right at the end where you want it. I'm going to start with the smaller pattern with the two pieces. You're going to line that part. And to keep it in place, I'm going to tack it. Kakiti, kakiti lang ya. You can have a thimble. Ticket. Thimble. Ticket. And I'm going to just tack those two pieces in the corner together. And I will show you that we sew from this end up, just the way my Anana taught me, or my Acha, my aunt. Okay. So hold those two pieces together. And you could leave it like that, because, and then you see this is smaller than this thumb, and that's where you start to gather around the thumb, and then you'll also gather around the top of the mitt as well. There's a right and left, but remember you're going to gather the top, around the top. Mikuti, needle, dikik, thimble, sino, ivalo. And the pattern is called ututi. So now I'm going to take these two and line it up with this corner as well to keep it in place. There's different ways of sewing. I'm just going over. Nitsuk, sewing. Nitsuk dunga, I am sewing. We were taught in elementary. Local women. My aunt being one of them. You have to try to make your seams the same. Same distance and the same length. As you can see. Okay, this part is done. There's a bit of a gap there. Because the front of the mitt is shorter than the one on the back. Okay. Use a knot, a different knot. So there's a loop, and you can put your needle through. And then you could sew it back up to hide. You don't really see the knot. If you don't want it to pull, you can tie a knot. Remember to tie a knot. Here's your ivalo. Your nikuti. You fold your ivalo over. So it was like this. Fold it over. And you start twisting your needle. You're holding your thread with your index and middle finger, and then you're twisting your needle around. And once you think you have enough, you could pull it through, and that's how you tie a knot. Okay? It's a puzzle. All right. So, I will sew the bottom part with the bigger part. I don't know if I'm making any sense. The pattern, ututi, can be from a family member. You can ask other Inuit for their pattern. If they say no, respectfully, you accept that decline. These patterns were shared with me by Leanne. And the finished mitt I showed you in the beginning is from my sister. Traditionally, the needle came from the caribou calf. And the sinew came from, it could come from caribou or whale. This is artificial sinew. Mitts can be made from seal skin, from any felt, any fur, wolf or rabbit fur. I've seen polar bear fur mitts. There are sealskin mitts. There can be furless sealskin mitts, ichaktik. And that's what we call the leather. You can undo your stitch if you didn't like it. I'm going to flip this inside out and you won't see the seams. Starting to shape a little bit like a mitt. So these two are attached on the sides now and together. I'm going to take what I pinned earlier off. The gathering is really an art. I'm going to make sure the top is in place before I start to gather. Again, you're just tacking the top. Just a loose stitch. You can cross it over to make sure it stays. Now there's still lots to gather here, but that's okay. It's not as centered. But now you can undo that tack you did for the middle. Ichitere is shrink. Ichitere is your, because the top is bigger. Remember, it's bigger. So you could see that we had to sew the thumb pieces together first. Okay, so here's the two pieces. You make sure they line up in that little curve there. You sew those together. And then once those two pieces are together, again, you line up that little piece there with this. The rounded part is what will gather at the top. That's what we're doing right now, is gathering. Where my sister's meticulous sewing. See where she gathered? What she did was she started from over here, and when she put her needle right through everything, and then at the end she pulled on the thread to tighten it. Okay, we'll do that with the leather, but we're doing the liner right now. And so remember the stitching was up and over? Now it's through. There we go. And we're gathering the bigger part, folding it. So I'll show you what my sister did. She would, like a sewing machine, she would in without tightening the seams. She continued sewing, gathering. Okay, and then she pulled tight all the way around. Use an old leather glove to help with when you want to pull your seams tighter. You want to pull gently because you don't want to rip your material. See the whole gathering? One thing to keep in mind is making sure this side and this side are about the same. Do you see the little mitt yet? Just rip your mitt. Right now. You want to sew these two pieces first. I'm going to make this one, the top one, the suede part. You still want to line up these. This will be like this, as opposed to the brown leather showing. It's so that your grip, you could have a bit of better grip. The idea is the leather will show on the thumb part. Seamo, artificial seamo. Don't forget there's a left and right pattern. You don't want to mix those up. You line. Oh, we should sew it inside out. So we know we want the leather, the suede leather showing on your palm. So we're just going to switch them over so that you see the brown of the palm, because you're going to turn them inside out. So I usually start where they need to be paired up. Maybe less than a half an inch down. Maybe half a centimeter. Start on the other side. We just take the needle out, leave that. There's about 4 stitches. And I'll go over to the other side. Oh, yes. Okay, it's a little too far down. So I'm gonna undo 1 stitch. Okay. That's fine. Because you don't want to sew all the way down. This is flipping up. I forgot. So I have to undo just to keep it in place. Maybe so there's 2 stitches there. All right. We're on the same page again, because you want to sew it inside out, because you're gonna take it apart after. On the other side. So I'll just tack it in that corner. This is the palm we're sewing. The thumb and the palm together first. You don't want your seams to show, and that's why you sew it inside out, and then when you flip it right side out, you don't see the seams. Mind you, it depends how tight your seams are. And you got to remember your right side pattern from your left side pattern. You don't want to be sewing 2 right-handed mitts. It has happened. And when you're dealing with fur, you have to make sure you know which way the fur is going, the grain of the fur. You can use, this is leather, cow leather. You could use deer hide. You can use faux leather. If you wanted to. And, or you could just use the duffel or felt for thinner, you know, maybe a spring, just a liner. You can embroider, as I was saying, or applique. It's really up to the seamstress. You can make designs with your sealskin or your leather to go on the back of the mat. I've seen embroidery on sealskin mats, on the duffel, the beautiful flowers, where there's just simple around the trim. On my last stitch, you see the loop? I put the needle through the loop. Okay. Knot it as close as you can to the edge. Okay, and to do that, you make a loop with your hand, you put the needle through, and with your hand, you control where the knot will be with your hand. You stretch it to make sure it goes all the way down, and then you could hold it down and make your knot as close as to the seams as possible. I don't know if you could see that. So I used my hand to manipulate the knot. Then I hold it down in place, and that's how I knot as close as possible, about two or three times. You want the knot a little bigger. There's the loop, right? I'm holding the loop, and then there's the string. I'm manipulating with the loop, stretching the loop, making sure it's close and the knot will be close to the seams. Okay, let's try that again. Here's my loop. I'm holding the loop. I put the string through the loop like a knot, but you're holding the loop and stretching it all the way down before you start to knot it. Okay, then you can hold it and the knot will stay close to the seams. We'll do it again. There's the loop, I'm holding it. Then I put the string through the loop. I'm stretching the loop and the string together at the same time. And as soon as it's way down, you could let go of the loop and tie your knot. So it's close to the seams and it's not all the way up here. You need it close to the seams. Okay, so that was a loop. So you make a loop, you string it through the loop, but you're holding the loop. Okay, and then you pull together the loop. You're still holding on to the loop. And because you're holding on to the loop and the string, it goes all the way down to where your knot is. Then you could put put your finger down on the knot and pull through. So now I've made about 3 knots, okay? When I cut it, so you could barely see where the knot is. All right, so those two are together, right? There's your thumb, there's your palm. You're going to flip them inside out, or right side out. So there's the palm. See, you don't see the seams, right? There's your thumb. It's gonna line up where the other ones were, okay? I'm just gonna flip it back. And I'm gonna flip this so you could see the leather. You could see the leather. And I flip this back. Because we want it. And remember that piece on the thumb. It's over here. Okay. So you're going to sew this side first. Make sure you line up that little corner. You know how to tie the knot now with your needle? You loop it through. Okay, you looped it through. You leave a bit to hang so you don't lose your needle. Okay, there's the other end. Okay, there's the other end. I'm going to fold. I folded over the needle, so there's a little loop. I'm holding the needle with the thread, and I'm twisting. Still holding on to the seam together. I'm twisting about 8 times. Okay, then I'm going to pull the needle through what we were twisting. And it made a knot. Okay? So, line those two together. There's my first seam. And I put that extra lip through the hoop, and then you're just gonna make sure you sew over it so it doesn't stick out or unthread. Okay. Or you could cut it too. It's still there. I'm sewing and making it makes it neater when you sew away that extra thread. Otherwise, it would be sticking out. So about half a millimeter down and half a millimeter over, or centimeter. But you want to make them same seams. Try to. And then the last two. So there's the hoop. Before I tighten the hoop, I'm going to take my needle, loop it through, and then tighten it. It's the last two seams. I'll do the same. Or to make it easier, while your needle's gone through each, you take that loop, put it over your needle, and you just put it through. I guess I could do one more. Okay, it's through. I take my loop, put it through the needle, take your needle, thread it through and through the loop. Now you could tie a knot. Remember to tie your knot close. Can you see it? There's my loop, right? So needle through the loop. Okay, don't tighten the needle yet. You want to tighten the loop first. So there's my hand tightening it. And then I'm now tightening the needle, the thread. Because when you put the needle through, you push really hard. You push it really hard through, and you don't want to move the leather too much. So that's why you hold it down. So, did you see that? The way I'm holding it. So I make sure it's placed flush to each other. And when I'm pushing the needle through, I'm also pushing with my left hand. You see that? I'm pushing this way and I'm pushing this way. Okay? Remember, the needle's sharp. So you want to be careful and know where your needle's going. Okay, so I'm pushing this way with this hand, letting gravity do its thing. I'm also pushing this way with the needle. So I'm pushing this way and this way, okay? You want to be careful with this artificial sinew. Get weak as you pull. So just make sure you're aware of where the needle and the thread is. You see where it's gathered and it's starting to frail. So I'm going to change my sinew. I'll show you the knot again. So there's my loop. I stretch the loop so it goes all the way to the end, to the there's the knot, right close to the leather. Stretch until the knot is close to the leather, pull through. Okay, here's the loop. Put your needle through. You're holding. You're holding them. Stretching both of them now. See that it's close to the leather. There's the loop. Put the needle through. I'm stretching both of them, but making sure I open that loop wider to make it go all the way down. And I pull it through. The knot is close to the leather. Right. I'm going to start on the other side. So now all three pieces are together. There's the palm. There's the thumb. We sewed those two together first. Then you sew the sides to the back. Now I'm going to start on the thumb side. Before I gather or change the way I sew, I'm going to sew it right up to about there, right? So I'll sew it right up to about there. So if you put the thumb up, kind of see if it starts to curve, that's where you're going to start gathering. Okay? You want to take the thickest piece. If it starts to gather like this, don't take the thinner pieces. The thinner pieces will just fray. I've threaded my needle. There's a little excess to make sure it never unthreads, right? You take the other end, you place it over the needle, and you twist about 8 or 9 times. Then you pull the needle through what you just twisted. What you twisted was a knot. So we sew away. I'll show you. Here's my first stitch close to the other knot. Oh, sorry. First stitch is close to the other knot. Going this up, we're going to sew up. All right, I won't go too far up, and then I'll do the same on the other side before I start to gather. You want to make them about the same, okay? My trick is I kind of fold it over, start to fold it over. And the first few, you know, we were going over like that. Now we're going to go through. Okay, we're going to. In this case, you want to make your knot bigger because of the tension on the gathering. You don't want the knot to pull through. Sit and watch my Anana I mean, when you're young and you can't pick up the needle yet because it's sharp and you need some strength, you know, to be able to pinch and control the needle. But growing up, we watch our moms, our Anana, sewing. Anana is mother. And we watched our mother sewing. They make it look so easy. You know, but it was years and years of practice, years, many, many mistakes, I'm sure. Is, you know, in the beginning, I had the pattern on the same side, like so many little rule of thumbs you gotta follow or remember. But don't get discouraged. I'm not perfect at gathering. But only practice time. Will help. Practice and time. Like that's a lot. Lots to gather still. And that's how Inuit learn. We watch our mothers first. The influence is subliminal. And they taught us in junior high. In the 80s. They don't have much cultural programming, sadly. Today, in schools anyway, but it's amazing connection to culture. My mom has passed, she passed 25 years ago, and this helps to connect me with her, with my childhood, with my culture. Imagine her mother did this with her. It's just brilliant, really. They had, like I said, bone needle. Initially, traditionally. That just amazes me because I'm struggling with just this Glover needle. I mean, it's probably dull from overuse, but I can't imagine sewing with a bone needle. There's still this much to gather. Try to shrink that from the other side. So we gathered. It looks pretty rough, right? I want to even it out a little. Go. We're gonna flip it inside out. Ulip. Ulisiyavu. Ulip is turning it inside out. See, the palm is the suede. Just using a pencil. Poalo. Atausi poalo. 1 mit. Poalo. 2 mits are poaluk. Anything with 2 is always emphasized. Poaluk. Okay. Let me try to put them in. Liner in. They're smaller than I expected. There you go. We have the right mitt. What I learned is I should gather here and here and then. But I didn't do that. That's fine. So to recap, there's 3 pieces. There's the back. This is the liner, the pattern. Pattern is ututi. You have to line this up with the thumb. There's the thumb. You line that up. There's the palm. It's a little bit of a brain twist with the palm. Because you see this part, that flips up, see? So there's the palm, and then there's the thumb. So you line those up. Okay, first you sew the palm and the thumb together first, like this, just where that little corner is. You don't go past that because this part is going to flip up and join the back, right? So it joined like that. Okay, I'll show you on the polo. So this one is the palm, okay, and it has bit of the thumb, right, that flips up, and then there's the thumb part, right? I'm sorry, it's dark. And then this is the back, so it's in 3 pieces. Once again, you sew the thumb and the palm first, just over here, right? You don't go all the way down, because you're going to flip the palm and the thumb will attach to the back right here. Okay, do you see that? Okay, so this is the thumb, there's the palm, and this is the back. Okay, so you sew the palm and the thumb together first. You don't go past the thumb. You just sew along here and over here, these two together, before you sew the back on. Okay? You're going to sew them ulisimatilugo, inside out. So the stitches don't show. Ulisi matilugu, when it's inside out, you sew, okay? The thumb and the palm together. So just along here, just to here. This part, the thumb and the palm and the back attach down here where there was that. Inside out, ulisimatilugu. There's the palm. The thumb goes up. Okay, the palm. See, this has to flip up. Okay. With the thumb, thumb piece, you're going to attach from that little corner all the way around, okay? All the way around. These two will look like this without the back, okay? There's no back yet. And then when you get the back, after you've sewn these together, don't forget, don't sew past, okay? Don't sew past this. When you attach these together, then the back, where that corner piece is all going to, you're gonna sew them together here. Okay, so this is the thumb. You don't go sewing to the thumb. These two are sewn together already. And you take the back and you pin them all three together with that corner, right? And you sew from the bottom up to that corner where you tacked. And then you go to the other side and you sew that side before you start to gather around the palm. Okay? So, I'll show you the seams. There's the palm. Here's the thumb. You sewed the palm and the thumb together, okay? They're sewn tacked this way. You're gonna sew from the bottom up to where they're tacked. You're gonna tack the middle of the big piece with the palm. Just a loose seam, so you can undo it after. You're going to sew just a little bit with the same seams up and over this way on both sides. And then you'll start to gather. When you gather, you're going to put your needle through and then through again. You're going through and through, not over anymore. And when you're gathering, you're gathering the back, the long piece. You're gonna make little curves. And each curve you make, you put the needle through that curve. Okay? And you gather, and you gather, and you gather. And then every once in a while, you pull. You don't pull from the needle, pull from the thread to make your gather tighter. Okay? After you're done, you're going to ulip. Turn it inside out. Should make them tighter. What you could do is get another piece of leather or fur, and you could make a trim. You can also sew the liner with the outer shell before you put your trim to kind of hide the rough edges and to protect it, because you're putting it on all the time. You're pulling on the mitt part all the time. So you want to put a trim around it to protect it. And see how it's curved a little? Because when you put your mitt on and you grab something, it's easier. It's already grip. There's grip, better grip when you have that little curve. Poilu, mitten, one poilu. When it's two, it's poiluk. Huyennamik, nakomik. Thank you for the opportunity. It's been a while since I've made a poilu, and I'm really excited to share it with you. Huyennamik. My name is U Akpik. I'm originally from Kimmerut and here in Ottawa. And I just made my tea bear his right hand mitt, which he'll probably fit for just this spring. Hey, Nakomik, thank you.